Hi guys, I'm going to show you how to make a simple YouTube background on Serif Draw Plus. This works for Serif Draw Plus Start Edition, which is the free version, for all the other ones. Okay, first you're going to want to download or save a picture of a proper sized YouTube background template. No, just plain black and white. Okay, and then you're going to want to open Serif Draw Plus up. Click here, open save work, and then find it. Mine's right here. And you'll see this, somewhat similar to this. Okay, you're going to want to come over to here with where the layers are. Click plus, which shows you what's in that layer. Then you're going to want to come over to this quick rectangle tool, click that. If it's on any other tool, just click that arrow beside it, like say it's on a circle, then just click that arrow and click quick rectangle. So you're going to click that, and then you're going to come over to this color wheel. Make sure it's set on HSL color wheel, because that's the best, I think. It may be set on that, or that color wheel's the best. Then you're gonna wanna come over to this black box, click it, then click the little gray and white square box underneath it, which makes it transparent. Then you're gonna wanna click the white box, and then you're gonna wanna drag this. Try and, like, say if I wanted pink, you drag so the black circle's on pink, then click inside the triangle and drag it towards the black circle. But I prefer using black, so I just use black. Gonna zoom in with Control Plus, and you're gonna want to, because this is all towards making a black rectangle in the middle, which is much more better, because you never know when YouTube's gonna update itself and your background will be ruined. So you're done with this, and then you've got this. And if you don't want a white background, and let me just test something. No, that didn't work. Ooh, I don't know what's going on. If you don't want a white background, then get the rectangle tool again, choose your color. I prefer using blue. Oops, this gone wrong. Okay, then you're gonna want to zoom in again to a corner using Control Plus. Sorry, let me redo that. Went wrong. And then just gonna wanna drag it. Oops, I did that middle rectangle wrong. Just gonna wanna drag it right to the bottom so it's covering your whole background. Okay, so that rectangle I'm gonna put as black. Okay, then you're gonna wanna come to your layer, click the rectangle, then click and hold, and then drag it underneath your bar in the middle so it does that. Control X to zoom out. Got this, and then you can go to make it look a bit more fancy. You can add some optical flares. You can get these from like downloading packs from YouTube, or just go onto your browser and type optical flares in. And then you can get some pretty good images. I think I'm gonna use this one. I like it the most. Okay, so you wanna get the biggest picture you can, like this. You're gonna wanna copy it, you're gonna wanna go on, gonna paste it. You'll do that, and then there might be some black bars around it. like this one. You're going to want to select it, go to this crop tool down here, and then drag it in just a little bit past the black bars. And then you're going to just click this black pointer tool up here. Gonna want to drag it and then click shift, and then you will come over, you'll keep it selected, you'll come over to the color wheel and it should have blend mode. You'll click scream and then it should do that to it, which gives it a nice effect on the background. You're going to want to drag it down like you did for the blue rectangle underneath the black rectangle. You're going to want to copy it if you want it on the other side. Paste it. And then the best way to do it, I believe, to flip it, because there's no other way. So get your ruler tools and then go right to the edge of it like this. And then you're going to drag it to the edge of the background like that. Keep it selected and then drag it like that. And then drag it underneath the black rectangle again and get rid of your ruler. Like so. And then you're going to want to add text in the middle probably. It looks better that way. You'll drag your template right to the top, get your text tool, drag down, and then type your name, your YouTube name into it, and then select Control A, and then select your font. I'm just going to use Pepsi, and then you'll go to effects and then go to glow. I prefer using this red glow, but there's a white glow and orange glow. I'll just use the red glow because I think that looks the best. And you'll put your name in the middle, maybe make it a bit smaller just for safety really, in case it gets blocked off by things. Okay, I'm just going to put subscribe here, because I'm probably going to make it available to download. Okay, so once you're done with that, you can select it and then you can see this material thickness here. I'll just zoom in so you can see what it does. You can see it transforms it. So make it from that to more a 3D effect like that. And then go onto your layers, delete your template like that, and then you could maybe go and get another optical flare like that, and then choose the flare you like. I think I'll go with this red one here. And then you'll drag and drop your flare, if you're getting it from a file, onto here, or just copy and paste it. Click screen. Screen works best on darker colours, by the way. You could maybe tint it to whatever colour you want. Like, no, that didn't work, so let's put that in there. Yeah, there. And then you can maybe make it smaller or bigger, depending on how you like it. I'm just going to flip it because I think it looked better that way. Then place it above the U. So there's how you make a simple background. Hope you found this helpful. Please comment, rate and subscribe. Thanks for watching.